Blackstone presents Consider the Octopus by Nora Raleigh Baskin and Gay Polisner. This book is read by Piper Goodeve and Michael Crouch. We only get one Earth and a few oceans. Thank you to all, especially the children, who step up to keep them clean and safe. I am here to say, our house is on fire. I want you to act as you would in a crisis. Greta Thunberg, 16. The day science begins to study non-physical phenomena, it will make more progress in one decade than in all the previous centuries of its existence. Nikola Tesla, dead.
Now. 1. Jeremy J.B., Face of the Oceania 2, Barnes. The Mylar balloons, tied tight to the metal leg of the folding registration table, twist and glitter in the sweltering sunshine, waiting for me to come bake next to them. Earlier, Marco and Randy had argued over them, him saying, "Balloons are festive and make it easier to find us, plus fine for the environment so long as we cut them in half and recycle them properly afterward." And her saying, "Fine, if you don't mind being a total hypocrite and part of the bigger problem." Besides, how hard is it to spot two registration tables in front of a ginormous research ship docked only a quarter mile off that says Oceania 2 in white across its whole green side? Marco had won, per usual, by making an executive decision, leaving Randy to glare at him. Now, I sit down next to the balloons on a wobbly folding chair and wait for the science geek C-mester kids to show up so I can start my super important job of checking them in. A mere 2 weeks ago, I would never have been given this Face of the Oceania 2 assignment, even in an emergency, so maybe Mom is right. Maybe the fresh air and thinking time are starting to rub off on me. Not that me doing this job was exactly everyone's first choice. Marco was supposed to do it, but there was some sort of emergency, all hands on deck, which meant Marco and Randy and Vance and even Sabira had to stay on board, which left only Henry and me to check everyone in. And since Henry can obviously schmooze better than I can about fancy science things, that put him in charge of the scientists and me checking in the semester kids. "If you're sure you can handle that?" Mom had asked, her words sounding more worried than like a big vote of confidence. Plus, she rumpled my hair, which isn't really something you should do if you want someone to feel fully competent. Besides, hadn't I just proved myself? Hadn't I located 10 of the 18 hard-to-find scientists from all over the globe? You think it's easy to tell a marine biologist from a climate biologist from a climatologist when they all have the same first name? Okay, well, at least two of them did. But this guy here? He did it, and got 10. 10 of the 18 hopefuls on Captain Jim's invite list. From Zhang Lu to Samara Redmond to Dr. Sidney Miller from the Marine Lab at the Monterey Bay Aquarium to RSVP, they were coming. I shift in my spot, glance at Henry still setting up his registration table, and then at the small brick building across the empty dock where ferry tickets are sold, wondering if I have time to run in and take a leak. But I can see cars beginning to pull in through the arrival zone, plus a shuttle bus, and I don't want to mess up by not being here to greet the first kids to arrive.
Sydney Miller. Nana's 15-year-old pumpkin-orange Subaru station wagon looks right at home in the parking lot of the Seattle Food Co-op warehouse. In fact, five spots down from where we are sitting in our car, there's another one almost identical, except that one has more bumper stickers. I know, right? Pretty hard to imagine, but there it is. See? Nana says, pointing to the orange twin car. Even the same dent on the passenger door. Now how do you explain that? I bet there are a ton of algorithms that could explain it, starting with the number of orange Subaru station wagons sold in any given year, like the demographic of people who purchased Subarus in relation to those living in the Seattle area, and then the number of those same people who kept their car for 10 years or more. I don't necessarily know the math to figure that all out, but I know there is some. At the same time, how can I ignore coincidences like that ever again? I mean, it's what brought me here in the first place. That's exactly the reason I am about to attempt to sneak onto a ship and sail out into the Pacific Ocean for 7 days. The reason? A ring toss game.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.